Last year, I decided to replay Lost Via Domus, a video game created by Ubisoft in 2008 that is based on the popular TV series. But halfway through my playthrough, I decided to see if there were ways to improve the graphics of the game, so I checked PC Gaming Wiki. I found nothing. Taking matters into my own hands, I stumbled upon the registry files for the game that included values for some of the graphical settings. Today, I will share these with you. Before we look at how to achieve this, I will demonstrate to you some of the improvements. Obviously, this is an old game, so keep your expectations quite low. The first area that we're going to look at is the draw distance. This mod disables the LOD transitions of 3D models for both characters and world objects. This means that no matter what the distance is from the player, the models with the highest polygon counts will always be rendered. This game has particularly bad model pop-in. As you're running through the jungle, by default, you can watch every tree pop into your view, and it's very distracting. This mod disables all of those transitions, so running through the jungle is a much more fluid experience. The next area looks at the quality of shadows. You can see here a comparison between the default low graphics, default high graphics, and the modified settings used today. The main improvement we see from the shadows is the distance in which they render at higher quality. It was impossible to create anything spectacular here. There still appears to be a limit on how far the shadows will render, and from playing with the settings for a while, these were the best results. The final override I will talk about is more of an experimental setting to adjust to your preference. Essentially, this setting allows you to set the amount of grass seen throughout the environments. By default, the highest value supported by the game is 10. But here is what it looks like set to 20. And here is it set to 50. And here is it set to 150. You can probably put any value you want here, but it might crash your computer if you do. I find this setting greatly improves the experience seen in the jungle sections by making the jungle seem much more dense. However, it has potential to make some scenes look incorrect, such as this scene in the beginning of the game, where Elliot is laying in the grass. Higher values will also lead to performance drops, especially when you force anti-aliasing as well. Now that we've seen some comparisons, it's time to set this up for ourselves. The easiest way to do this is to open your Start menu and type in Registry Editor. Open the Registry Editor. Now, press Edit and Find. Type in Lost Via Domus, and then press Find Next. You will need to press this a few times until you see that you have landed in the Ubisoft Lost Via Domus 1.0 Engine, Game, and Launcher folders. Once you have found these, press Engine. In here, you can see all of the values that you can change. Some of these values don't appear to make much difference to the game. Some of them will make the game look better at higher values, and some of them will make the game look better at lower values. But here are the values that I would recommend you change. Character Mesh LOD Coefficient, 0. Character Shader LOD Coefficient, 0. Character Starting Mesh LOD, 0. Detail Grass Density Scale, I've set this to 50, but you can set this to whatever you'd like. Detail Grass Fade Distance Scale, I've set this to 100, but again, you can increase this if you wish. Environment Mesh LOD Coefficient, 0. Environment Shader LOD Coefficient, 0. Environment Starting Mesh LOD, 0. I've also changed the Mesh LOD Transition Multiplier to 50, but I'm not sure if this makes too much of a difference since we've disabled most of the transitions. Shadow Blur Quality seems to be maxed out at 3. For the Shadow Buffer Resolution, I'm not entirely sure what to set for this value, but I've just put 6 nines in the box, and it appears to make the game look as good as possible. Finally, for shadow draw distance, you can set this to 20. Increasing beyond this value seems to make the shadows look worse. So that's it for the graphical adjustments. It is worth noting that the game does not include any anti-aliasing, but this can be overridden. I've only been able to test this with Nvidia, but you might be able to find another way to do this if you have a different type of card. You will need to download Nvidia Inspector first in order to do this. Once you have downloaded it, open the drop-down selection box at the top of the screen, then select Lost Via Domus. Towards the top of the page, you will see anti-aliasing compatibility. You will need to change the last 4 zeros here to 1, 2, C, 1. Then change anti-aliasing fix to on. Scrolling down the page into section 3, anti-aliasing, change anti-aliasing mode to override any application setting. For anti-aliasing setting, you can either put 8 times Q or 4 times. I've used 4 times. For anti-aliasing transparency multi-sampling, put enabled. And finally, anti-aliasing transparency supersampling, I've put to 4 times sparse grid supersampling, but you can also put 8 times here if you wish. And that's it. If that has worked correctly, anti-aliasing should now work the next time you've booted into the game. A final quality of life fix for Lost Via Domus is to remove the intro splash screens. This is very straightforward to do. Navigate to the installation directory for the game and locate the videos folder. From there, rename or delete the following files: ABC, ESRB, LOCEN UB Presents, Logo Ubisoft, Peggy, and PhysX. The names of these files may differ, dependent on the language of installation. I would also recommend that you use a controller to play the game, as it feels a lot easier to use than using keyboard and mouse. But you can keep a keyboard nearby, as when you're using the Hatch computer, the keyboard works well to imitate using the computer in the game. That brings us to the end of today's video. I hope you've enjoyed it and found it useful. I plan to make more Lost Via Domus content in the future, mainly a retrospective, which will look deeply into the game design and story. If that sounds interesting, make sure you subscribe. But that's all for today's video. I'll see you in the next one.